Anthony, for the University Course Instructor. So, in the previous two video lectures, we had discussed about the component of the discrete statistics, okay? That of the data collection and the data summarization, the data presentation in the organization. So, today we try to see the second component, which is the data summarization, specifically data summarization using the measure of central tendency. So, what is the central tendency? Okay, so these are the most important points in the world of biostatistics. Okay, so we're going to apply when you conduct a research. Okay, so when you conduct CDTP and TTP and different others, okay, so different others, so which needs data summarization, so you will going to apply, okay, you are going to apply this measure of central tendency. So you need to know, okay, you need to know specifically the mean, the median, and the mode. Okay, so they are the most important. So what are central tendency? So these are the score that indicates where the center of the distribution tends to be located. Okay, so these are the score or the value which helps us just to identify the center of the distribution of the data. So that distribution could be the normally distributed in case of the mean, median, and the mode. Become equal, or it could be negatively, okay, negatively skewed, or it could be positively skewed, okay, because most of the times the mean can be just affected by the extreme value. So in case of the negative distribution, so this also tells us that the mean has been just affected, okay, the mean has been just affected. So in this case, we're going to use that of the median. So this measure of central tendency are also sometimes called the measure of central rotation. So the main objective of this measure of central tendency are just to condense or to present or to summarize the data in a single value. So that single value could be the mean, the median, or the mode. Okay? So with whatever the sample type is, whether it could be 10, 100, 10,000, or million, okay? So that sample, specifically or particularly quantitative variables, can be just summarized, can be condensed, can be presented in a single. To facilitate the comparison between two data. Okay, the two data can also be just helpful just to, for the comparison. Section A and the section B can also be just compared based on their mean average square or the mean or average score of biostatistics exam or by the median of their exam score. Okay, so we can compare. So one group may be just better than the other group. Simply by observing them, by observing their mean, median, and the mode value. Okay, so the most common measure of central tendency are the mean, the median, and the mode. Okay, mind you, so these are familiar. I thought you have just learned in mathematics. Okay, in the high school mathematics. So they are simple. Okay. So the first one is the arithmetic mean. So mean, by the way, mean is the most common, okay? The most common as well as popular form of data summarization, okay? Data summarization. So this mean about the arithmetic mean, which is the average set of the observation. So mean is average, okay? So this can be just obtained simply by the summation, okay? By adding all the observations, then dividing by their numbers, okay? By the total sample size, okay, by total sample size. So this also helps us just to summarize both the discrete and the continuous variables. So if you remember from the beginning class, so the variables can be classified into two, the quantitative variables and the continuous variables. So mean have value for the discrete as well as the continuous variable, so does not have any, okay, meaning for the quantitative one. So mind you, for example, can be possible or is it possible just to calculate the mean of name, okay, sex, for example, sex is quantitative variable. So is it possible just to calculate the mean or the average of sex? It could not be, okay, it could not be. So mean can be just used to summarize the data which comes from the discrete or the continuous variable. So discrete means, for example, that has an interruption in between the units, okay? That does not, that, okay, that does not have any interruption between them are the continuous variable, while the one that have the gaps in between them is the discrete. For example, number of change gap, okay? For instance, hate. When you say hate, so there is no gap, okay? There is no any gap between the numbers. So 1.1, 1.2, 1.3, and 1.4. So when you say discrete, there is a gap in between them. For example, can we say 1.1 children, 1.2 children? No, we can't. Okay, so that the most peculiar feature of the mean is it's always present. Okay, always present, whether it is 2, 3, or 4. So simplicity is just the calculation of mean is very simple. Okay, very very simple. So it is unique. Okay, so unique for one data there is one mean. Okay, one mean value. So one of the peculiar. Okay, one of the peculiar feature it does not seen in other form of the central tendency measurement is the highly affected. Okay, mean can be highly affected or distracted or destroyed by extreme values. Okay, both extreme values, the largest value and the smallest value. So you can exercise it. Okay, you can exercise it by yourself. But mean in general it can be just affected. So most of them, the mean can be pulled to the largest number. Okay, the largest number. So mean cannot be used when the data is not normally distributed. If the data is not normally distributed, so it's not possible just to summarize our data using mean. Okay, so we need to consider that. So this is the general formula. This general formula just for the calculation of the mean. Okay, so this is the summation. This with n observation. Okay, so here observation 1, observation 2, and up to n observations. So the summation, then we'll try to add all the observations and we'll divide to the sample size. So this is, this formula is just can be just used for the group data. Okay, if the data has been just grouped, so if you remember from the previous class, so grouped, okay, frequency can be just can be put in the form of interval, isn't it? So during that, so we need to calculate the midpoint. Okay, the midpoint, then we'll try to multiply by the frequency, then finally we'll try to divide by the summation of the frequency. So k means a class interval. Okay, so this can be just the class interval, it could be from 1 and end up to k class interval. Then finally the, we'll try to see, okay, an example. So here let's say the simplest example. Okay, compute the sample mean for the following example. So this since this is a 100 from biostatics. Okay, biostatics continuous assessment out of 100%. So this is almost 11 students. Okay, among 11 students. So started from 65, 55, 89, and so on. Okay, so these are 11 in number. So just to calculate the mean, simply just add. Okay, 65 plus 55 by 89 plus 56. Then finally we try to divide by 11. So the average score. Okay, the average score of these 12 students is 59. Okay, 59. So does not mean that there is no above or below the mean value. So there are a number of values which are above the mean. Okay, above the mean. So for example, if you see the mean is for one observation is here, there is what? There is 14. Now you see there is 14. But the mean has been just pulled to 262. That means the mean value is a little bit higher than the 14. Okay, higher than 14 is 35. Because there is a largest number here, which is what? 92. Again, this is the smallest number. So both numbers can affect. Okay? Both numbers can affect. So just to understand this, you can change 14 into to 44. The group data. Okay, so already we have seen the formula. So let's say the example. Okay, so consider the time taken by 30 students to do a biostatic quiz. Okay, biostatic quiz exam. So this is 1 to 5. Okay, well, that means just from 1 minute up to 5 minutes, two students just completed the quiz. From 6 to 10 minutes, 12 students completed the quiz. And from 11 to 20 minutes, so 16 students completed the exam. Totally, 30 students has taken the exam. So this is the number of students. So in short, this is the frequency. Okay, the frequency. So just we need to calculate the true class interval. True class interval can be just obtained by subtracting 0.5 from the lower limit. The lower limit of the class interval is 1, I think 1 minus 0.5, so it is 0.5, and adding 0.5 to the upper limit, adding 0.5 to the upper limit, so the upper limit is 5, so we are going to add 0.5 to the upper limit, so 0.5 up to 5.5, so the true limit, the true class limit can be this one. So we'll try to find out the midpoint. The midpoint can be found by adding the lower, the true lower class interval plus the upper true lower class interval. 0.5 plus 0.5. Then multiply the midpoint by the frequency. So this class frequency is 2. 2 times 6, 2 times 3 is 6. So again here, the lower limit is 6. So just to find the true class interval, we need to subtract 0.5 from 6, and we are going to add 0.5 to 10. So that is 5.5 to 10.5. Then 5.5 plus 10.5 is 16 divided by 2 is 8. 8 times 12 is 16. 656, 96. So here 11 up to 20. So the lower limit is 11, so we need to subtract from 11 0.5, then 10.5 will be obtained. From 20 0.5, so 20 plus 0.5, so 20.5, so finally 15.5, totally 15.5, sorry, just to say this, it is 15, 15. So, totally, when you add, so we obtain 350, so this is the mean of the data score, the mean of the student's time that has been just taken to finish the queues is 11.7 minutes, this is the average, so, just for the class, for self-test, just do this one. This is the class interval. So just simply find out the median, the midpoint, put the midpoint, then multiply the midpoint with the frequency that you can obtain, So here the same thing. So hence, the mean value is 155.8549. So we didn't approximate to 156. So just you need to take it as it is because it is a continuous variable. So the median, which is the second most popular form of data summarization, it is the second most form of data summarization specifically for the central tendency. So it is a middle. The future or the killer feature of the mean is it needs just to find out the median. So first we need to identify or we need to arrange the data in the order array. Serial arrangement, either ascending or descending. So most of the time it is ascendingly. Ascending data arrangement is mandatory in case of the median. So it is the value that divides the data set into two equal parts, equal halves when they are arranged in order. So we can see that 50% of the data are found below this and 50% are found above this, above that cutoff point. That cutoff point is a median. So to find out the median of a group value, so we need to arrange the data in order array from the smallest to the largest, or just putting into the order array. The characteristics of the median, so just like that of the mean, median also is simple for the calculation. It's simple, it's very simple. And it's also unique, just like that of the mean. And the value of the median is not this much affected by the presence of extreme values. What needs the median is just simple arrangement, serial arrangement of the data. sophisticated are elements of the data. So the calculation of the median can be of two types. So this n plus 2, n is the number of observations, plus 1 divided by 2. So this observation is the median class when n is odd, or when the observation is odd. So that means, for example, if the sample size is, whether it's 3, it could be 3, or it could be 5, it could be 7, it could be 9, it could be 11, it could be 13, 15, 17, and so on to anywhere. So in this case, simply add, okay, 1 to the sample size and divide by 2. Then that term is, or that observation is the median class. But when you come to the even distribution of the data, when the data is even, or when the observation is even, so we need to take the average of the n over 2 observation in the n over 2 plus 1 observation. Okay, the n over 2 plus 1 observation. So we'll try to see an example. So, for instance, here, look at here, compute the median. So try to apply this formula, okay? Since this, since it is odd, we are going to apply this one. Okay, we are going to apply this odd. So n plus 1 over 2. So n is what? 5. Plus 1, 6. Divided by 2, 3. So number 3 odd, the number 3 observation is the median class. 1, 2, 3. So by default, this is also 3. So this is the number 3, observation 3. So this is the median class. So 50% of the data are found above the mean, is above the median, and 50% are found below the median. The median is 3. So 50% are found above 3, and 50% are found below 3. Isn't it? Yeah. There are here, there are two observations, and above 3 also there are two observations. Are we got it? Good. So here compute the median for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So in this case the observation is even, isn't it? So we need to apply this one, okay? We need to apply the second formula. Okay, the second formula, this one. First we need to find n over 2. N over 2 is n is 6 divided by 2, 3. The number 3 plus n over 2, 3 plus 1, 4. So the number 3 and the number 4. Okay, the average of number 3 and then number 4 is the median. That means 3 plus 4 is 7 divided by 2 is 3.5. So note that 3 numbers are less than 3.5 and the 3 median required. So median is, it divides the data set into 2. Good way. So if the data is grouped, in case of grouped data, so there is a formula that can be just used to calculate the median. Okay, this is the median for just to calculate in case of grouped data. In case of grouped data. Okay, so that is for the previous one is for the simple data. Okay, for the simple data, if the sample size is less than 20, but if the sample size is greater than 20, and if there is a need to be just grouped the data, so we need to calculate the median using this formula. Okay, so there is two steps just to calculate the median, so we need to follow these two steps. The first one is identifying the median class. The median class from the data or from the class interval, so we need to determine. How can we determine? So as we know, median can divide the data set into two. That means 50% below, 50% above. So the sample size can be divided up into two, n over 2. N means the number of observations. If the observation is 10, 10 by 2, 10. 5 is the median class. So we are going to find that 5. And then step 2, estimate the median value within the median class using the following formula. So LM means the lower limit of the median class, okay? The lower limit of the median class, and while F1 is the cumulative frequency before the median class, okay? This is the cumulative frequency. So here we need to calculate the cumulative frequency. And F50 is the frequency of the median class. The frequency of the median class could also be just calculated. And W is the class interval of the size. So I will show you with the example. So here it is, okay? So compute the median for the following group data. So this is the class interval. So the total number size is what? 62. Just the first step in the calculation of the median error. Determine the median, limit n over 2, n is 62. So when you divide by 2, you obtain 31. N divided by 2 will give it 31. So 31 observation is the median. So where does this 31 can be found? Where does this 31 can be found? So for 3, 12, okay, and so on, 23, 14, 6, 4. So here, just to find out the quality frequency of this interval, so we are going to add this frequency plus the previous frequency, okay, before this one. So there is one frequency before this class interval, so we'll put it 3 as it is. Just to find out the quality frequency for this interval, so we are going to add 12 plus 3 is 15. Just like this, we try to finish calculating for the quality frequency. Then n 31. So when you come to here, so is there any 13? No, this is 3 observation. When you come to here, 15 observation. So can one found 31 here? No. So here 38. So 38 can also in 31. So 31 can be found within this one, within this interval. So within this interval. So we have already determined the class interval. The class interval. So here the lower limit of the class is 150. Okay, the lower limit, L limit 150. And the other is the commutative frequency above the median class. The median class is this one. Okay? So the commutative frequency above the median class. So the median commutative frequency this one is above this one is what? 15. Okay, 15. So this is here, there is 15 here. So F1 is the commutative frequency above the median, which is 15. The other is F50, the median class frequency. It's not the commutative frequency, mind you. The median class frequency, which is 23. Okay, which is 23. And the class width, or the width is 10, already 130 up to 139 is 30. Okay, 10. So the width is 10. So here, just simply substitute. Okay, LM is the lower limit is 150 plus n over 2 is 31 minus f1 is 15 divided by what? 23 times 10. So you will obtain 956.9565. Okay, 9565. So it seems a little bit, it seems difficult, but it's not difficult when you practice. Okay, just practice by listening my calculations. So if you have any concern or question, just you can ask me anytime. Okay, don't hesitate. So here is also self exercise. Okay, self exercise. Just find the median. Okay, the same. First, you need to determine n, lm, the lower limit of the median class. F1 the commutative frequency above the median class, F50 means the median class frequency, W means the width, so you need to calculate this one, okay? You need to calculate. So the third mode of data summarization is the mode, okay? Mode is the value that has the highest frequency in a set of values, or it is the most frequent observation in a set of observations. So mode is it is used to summarize qualitative data. Okay, qualitative data. For example, sex is qualitative data. So which is the most frequent sex? Okay, we can say which is the most frequent sex, male or female? Female, we can say. Okay, or for example, religion. Okay, religion is also the quantitative variables. Okay, multi-quotables. Religion is a multi-quotable. So which religion is most frequently occurred? We can say that. Okay, we can say that. So mode is another form of data summarization. So mode can be characterized by it could be present or it could not be present. So as you see from the two features of the mean and the median, both the mean and the median always present. Okay, they always present. But the mode, it could present or it could absent. Okay, if the mode present is not unique. Okay, it's not unique. Mode is not unique. Unlike unlike that of the mean and the median, mode is not unique, okay? Because the mean and the median, they are unique. Why it's not unique? The mode can be 2, 3, or 4. Just like that of the mean and the median, the mode is also very simple just to calculate. So, for example, from here, what is the mode of the following data? Okay, this is the score of the barostatic Qs, okay? Let's say this is the Qs. So one student scores something, one student scores 0, and four students scored, okay? And 14, 6 times, okay? 13, 4 times, 12, 1 times, 11, 1 times, 10, 1 times. So from this, which score has been just repeated more or occurred frequently? That is 14, okay? 14. So 6 students scored 14, so this is the mode, okay? This is unimodal. So mode is only is 5, okay? Unimodal means when the mode have only 1, okay? When the mode of the distribution is only 1. So that is what is the mode of the following data, for example, okay? Here you can see, for example, 15, okay, has been just occurred 5 times, and the 12 has been just occurred 2 times. So here we can say this is what? Unimodal. So that's why mode is not unique, okay? That's why mode is not unique. So this is bimodal distribution, because the distribution has 2 scores that are the most frequently occurred, okay? So here, for example, this example, okay? So 22, 66, 69, 77, 73. Here there is no mode. So mode, it could be present or it could not be present. Okay. So from here, the modal is 3 gauge. So you can find. So you can also just read in load. Okay. So now we try to see how to calculate the mode for group data. Okay. So we need to follow the same thing for the two-step procedures, okay, like that of the media. So first, you need to identify the modal class, which is the classes that has the highest frequencies. There would be candidates in which the modes can be just found, okay? Number two, estimate the modal within the modal class at the class point, okay? So here it is, okay? So this is the modal. Okay, class is the lowerly boundary of the modal class plus change 1 over change 1 plus change 2 times the h. H means the width or the class interval. Okay, what is change 1 means? It is the difference between the frequency between the modal class and the class before the modal class. Okay, before the modal class. And change 2 is the difference between the modal class and after the modal class. Okay, after the modal class. So we'll try to see with the example. Here, for example, this is here. First, we need to identify from the steps. First, we need to identify the modal class. That means the one which has occurred. Okay, from this, for example, this class interval occurs 3 times. This class interval has 12 frequency. This one has 23 frequency. So this is what? Here, there is 23. So 23 is the most frequent one. So the mode is found in this one, okay, in this. So here the class interval is already known, 130. Okay, the class interval is already known, it is 130. While the lower limit of the modal class is 150, okay, the change one means the frequency, okay, the frequency. The difference between the modal class frequency and the before is 23 minus 12, and the change 2 means the frequency or the difference of the modal class frequency and the after the modal class frequency. This is after the frequency that has been just come after the modal frequency. Okay, 23 minus 40. Okay, 23 minus 40. So you can, in this case, you can also see that the answer is 155. Okay? I will give you a worksheet, and that worksheet helps you just develop more skill. Okay, more skill. So these are elementary. Okay, elementary. So you need to read, you need to practice, you need to also update yourself. Okay, with different mode of calculation and with different more of knowledge. Okay, you need to also. I think this is enough for today. So I will give you a next lecture on the data summarizing using more the measure of variation, okay, or dispersion. So thank you very much. Hope we'll see you soon. Thank you. Goodbye.